Today on Zoom, get set, go! Come on.
Have you ever gone to a circus and see clowns make balloon animals? Well, I'm going to show you how to make this balloon dog.
Love it! I'm a lovey, top of lovey, lovey!
Oh, here comes Francis!
Come on, Francis!
Rachel Foster's back!
Funding for Zoom is provided by
the National Science Foundation,
America's investment in the future, the Corporation for Public Broadcasting,
a private corporation funded by the American people,
and by
contributions to your PBS station
from viewers like you.
Thanks!
Hey, Francis!
Come on, everybody!
We're going to do lots of different things with balloons. The first one is this zinger. Miriam G. of Chicago, Illinois, challenged us to keep a balloon in the air for as long as we can. We're allowed to hit the balloon with any part of our body except for our heads. Also, we can hit the balloon more than once in a row. Okay, guys, let's play.
Ready?
Okay.
I use different things each time.
Yeah. It's like an instinct, though, to use my head. I don't know why.
Yeah.
Like, I keep thinking it's true.
You almost use your head.
I'm moving. I'm just like, had to do this.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I almost cuddled.
Oh!
Oh, that's her.
No, I didn't.
Oh, no, no. Oh, see? You're so quiet.
Oh!
How about this time, you can only use your head.
Hey, Rachel. Yeah, Kaylee? How did the skunk call home?
I don't know.
He used his smellular phone.
P.U.
Lava! I'm a bubbin' of a scubbin! Abbott's of a bubbard!
Abbott's of a clubbing!
Nabo! Abbott's abba bubby dabba bubby mubbin!
Abba bubby dabba bubby mubbin! Abba bubby dabba bubby mubbin!
Lubba bubber gubba double lubba bubba bubble lubbun blubbun hubba bubber dubba bubber tubby.
Hubba? Dubba 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 cubba bubba or hubba?
Wubba! Ubba dubba dubba bubby mubbin! Mubby hubber ubba!
Dubba subbate, ubba smubby! Ubba dubba hubber tubby subbate dubba dubba! Wubba smubby! Subbu bubber! Rubba!
Bellies! Abba bubby dubba bubby mubbin!
Double nubby double stomach, mummy. Of I'm of a mummy double mummy, my man. Of it's my job up. Bye bye! Review of the picture book, The True Story of the Three Little Pigs, written by John Chesca and illustrated by Lane Smith. Helen D. sent us an email telling us what she thought of it. I love your show, and I love to read, so I'm sending you a review. This book is really entertaining and funny because it tells the story from the wolf's point of view. After you read it, you start to think of the good little wolf, who everyone treated unfairly, and the big bad pigs, who were so rude to him and ruined his reputation. Instead of the big bad wolf and the three little pigs. Personally, I am now siding with the wolf.
Do you know a book that you just couldn't stop reading? Well, we want to know about it. So send us your review. Don't forget to tell us the title of the book, what it's about, and why you like it.
You've got to send us email.
Send it to Zoom.
Email.
PBSKids.org.
Email.
Zoom. Zoom. Zoom.
PBSKids.org.
Asha C. of Calgary, Alberta, in Canada, challenged us to make a balloon boat using a milk carton, tape, straws, balloons, and string. We're going to work in teams of two to build our balloon boat. After we build them, we're going to attach them to this track so that our balloon boat can go straight. And then we're going to race them. You guys ready?
Yeah.
Okay, I had an idea that maybe we could cut a square right here to make it open, or like just a flap, and then we could put a balloon in there, and we could cut a hole and put the end of the balloon and blow it up inside.
The balloon should be like kind of motor.
Yeah, like,
but I think it should go underwater and then blow it up and hold the end, and then as soon as we're about to let it go, then the air will come out and it might shoot.
Yeah. You put it in like this, and then from there, poke a hole through here and put in it, and then blow it, because that will be too hard to.
How about we just put the balloon in, then take the end out of the hole and blow it up while it's still in here.
Okay, ready?
Don't make it too big.
I just want to make sure it's in the middle, so
yeah.
It's...
Yeah.
Whoa, thanks.
You rock! That is awesome!
Yep. Oh, geez.
We thought that was going to be big enough.
Yeah.
Hey, try again.
Here.
I think
this is cool.
A straw to the top of the milk carton so we can stick the straw through this string so the balloon shoots down the string.
Okay, let's just see if it would work right now.
Yeah, it works. It just needs
to go straight. It just needs more air or something.
You got it?
Yeah.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. So what we could do is
two balloons on the side.
No, put just a hole right here, another flap right here, that the air, the water would come in, but right there, and then the balloon can go out. This balloon can go out that the side.
Oh.
What if the balloon was actually sticking out of the milk carton so that we could get it bigger and have more air in it, and it would just shoot out?
Oh, okay.
Okay, that's good.
What?
Oh, wait, hold on. Don't blow anymore. It's going to pop.
It is?
Yeah.
Then we need to cut this whole top.
Yeah.
Cut this whole top off.
Oh, cool.
What? So you want to attach a straw and then just cut?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, no. Since the balloon sticks up, it won't go into us.
That's okay. We can just... Okay, that
yeah,
did not
thinking,
work.
If it doesn't go underwater, it's a balloon. It'll stay up.
Ready? Let it go.
I think the same thing with us.
I don't know. What do we change?
Nothing. We just move the straw from this side to right here.
Oh, I think that's much better.
Yeah, because then the balloon would be in the water.
I think we should make a bigger hole.
Okay.
Perfect.
Okay. You guys want to make this a race?
All right.
Let's do it.
Okay. Ready? On your mark.
Okay.
Get set. Go.
Hey, it sort of went.
Yeah.
I won.
You want to try again?
Sure.
I think by making the hole smaller, like that, because this one was way too big.
Yeah, too much air would come out.
So making it smaller was that.
Oh, that's a good idea.
I think it was a really good idea that we made that hole right there.
Yeah,
I think
it'll,
I think
it'll work much better.
Yeah, but the hole's much bigger than our hole before.
On your mark. Get set.
Set.
Go.
Come on, come on.
Yeah.
Good job, you guys.
Great job.
I only went a little bit farther.
Hey, I like that.
Good
job. Hey, Kenny.
Yeah, Rachel?
Why did the boy bring a skunk to school?
I don't know.
For showing smell. Get it? Show and smell?
Oh, show and smell.
I love peanut butter. Most kids have no idea where it comes from, but today I'm going to show you.
My name is Garrett. I'm 11 years old. I'm from Sumner, Georgia. And this is a peanut field. My whole family's in the peanut. My little brother and sister are in the peanut. My daddy's in the peanut. My mom's in the peanut. And my other little sister, Little Miss Georgia Peanut Corn's in the peanut.
Did you know a peanut really isn't a nut? A peanut is a legume. Legumes go on the ground and have a soft shell. These little peanut seeds are planted in April and May. After the seeds are planted, we have a lot of work to do. We need to water the plants, and we need to spray the plants to keep the weeds and bugs away. Amazingly, after 130 days, they turn into this. And then it's time for harvesting. This is an inverter. It digs the peanuts out of the ground and flips them upside down so that the peanuts can dry. Once peanuts are turned, they sit out in the sun for 3 to 5 days, and they get to look good and dry like these. And then we get to pick them, which is my favorite part, because believe it or not, I get to drive this big, humongous, huge tractor.
I rode with Daddy. I watched very closely, and then he started riding beside me, and then finally, he let me drive by myself. A peanut combine has fingers that picks up peanuts, and the peanuts go up to the basket, and the hay goes out the back.
When we take peanuts to the peanut company, first they get blown and dry. Then we take them to the cleaners, and then they get dumped out of a wagon into a big pit. Then they are sucked up into the pipes to get cleaned. And from there, peanuts are turned into peanut butter, peanut brittle, peanut oil, and boiled peanuts. These are boiled peanuts. If you've never had boiled peanuts, peanuts are mixed with salt, water, and boiled. They may be mushy, but trust me, they're delicious.
So that's where peanuts come from. Next time you have a peanut butter sandwich, think about that. Boy, this is sticky. I wish I had some milk.
As I Twinkled, a poem by Caitlin T. of Kingsville, Maryland. As I twinkled in the sky, I saw a planet passing by. The planet was Venus, the morning star, up in space, very far. Spinning on a tilt, it was, with clouds on top that looked like fuzz. The fuzz was thick, thick as can be, making it so I could not see. Then came the morning, and I faded away. I follow this pattern each and every day.
Zoomdo. Have you ever gone to a circus and see clowns make balloon animals? Did you ever wonder how they did it? Well, I'm going to show you how to make this balloon dog. Jenna Z of High Park, Pennsylvania, emailed us the directions. Here's what you'll need. One long skinny balloon. You can get this at a craft store or at a party store. And a pump to blow up your balloon. Or someone in the house who's really good at blowing balloons up. Here's what you do. Take the balloon and put it in the pump. And then just blow it up. You want to leave about 2 inches at the end uninflated. But I found it easier if you blow it all the way up and then let some air out. So there's 2 inches at the end. There. Then you want to tie the other end of the balloon into a knot so none of the air gets out. Like that. Okay. Then put your hands next to each other, near the knot, and twist them in opposite directions. And whenever you twist something, make sure you always hold the knot, the twist, so it doesn't become untwisted, like that. So anytime you twist, just hold it. Okay, so you want to twist a medium bubble and two small bubbles. One, two. So it's like this. Then you need to twist the two small bubbles together. To do this, put them next to each other and twist their bottoms so they're connected. It may feel like it's gonna pop, but it shouldn't because it usually doesn't. So it looks like that. Because now you have the dog's head, his ears, and that knot is his nose. Okay? Now twist a small bubble right underneath the ears. Oops, too small. And two medium bubbles. One. Two. Okay. Now put them next to each other so they're together, like this, and twist their bottoms like that, so they're connected. Now you have the dog's neck and its front legs. Now at the other end of the balloon, make a small bubble and two more medium bubbles. Okay. Oops. Small, medium, medium. Then you put the two mediums together so they're next to each other and twist those bottoms together so they're connected. Like that. So now you have the dog's tail and its back legs. And voila! You have your balloon dog. You can make all sorts of animals out of balloons, like this giraffe. You can see the long neck and its legs and its tail. Or you can make this bumblebee. This is his stinger and his wings. To find the directions to all these animals, you can visit the Zoom website at pbskids.org.
Kaylee.
Yeah, Eric?
What do you get when you cross a skunk with a police officer?
I don't know.
Law and owner.
The members of the Zoom team. The Grove School second graders of Northbrook, Illinois, baked 2,650 cookies and donated them to 21 different homeless shelters. That's a lot of cookies. Nice work, second graders. Do you want to be a member of the Zoom team, but aren't sure how to get started? Well, check out the Zoom website, where you can learn how to volunteer and see what other kids are doing.
Zoom into action.
Zoom into action.
And join the Zoom team!
Kaylee, I have a balloon here with a bendy straw inside of it, and it's all attached by an elastic band. What do you think's going to happen when I let it go?
Well, I know that if I blow this balloon up without a straw, then it will just go and fly all over the place. So, here.
Whoa. Whoa!
Now would I. So, I think maybe the straw prevents the balloon from blowing all over the place, but maybe it will do the same thing but stay on the table. Instead of flying in the air, maybe it will just stay.
Okay. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Whoa!
It's still spinning.
Still going.
Whoa.
That is funky.
Look at that. It goes so fast.
Eric P. of Tinley Park, Illinois, sent us the directions to do this experiment. All you have to do is take a bendy straw, like this, and cut about 2 inches off the bottom of it. So this will be the bottom straw. Yeah, it's about 2 inches. Yeah. Take the balloon and put the bottom end of the bendy straw inside of it, like this. And then take an elastic band and wrap it around the balloon so that it stays in place. So I'll wrap it around.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll do it.
You want me to hold it?
Sure, if you could. All right, I'll do it this way. There. And then, blow up the balloon and see what happens. Ready?
I'm ready.
Woo! Awesome!
Let's do that again. It fell down.
In order to get out, the air has to pass through the curve in the bendy straw. When the air turns the corner, it pushes on the straw, and the straw pushes back on the air. Then, the straw pushes in the balloon. And see what happens to the balloon? Spins.
So, let's experiment. What do you think would happen if we changed the direction that the straw points?
I don't know. Let's find out.
Okay.
So, last time, had it facing this way,
mm-hmm.
and it blew counterclockwise, like that.
Mm-hmm. Now,
I think if we do it this way,
yeah.
it'll blow the opposite direction, clockwise.
Okay, let's see.
All right, you ready?
Okay. Oh, you were right.
Neat.
Well, that was cool. Now it's time for you to experiment. Think of a question that you want answered. Like, what would you have to do to get the balloon to not go in a circle? Make a prediction, test it out, and then send your results to Zoom.
Got a phenom to present? A wicked, sweet experiment?
Send a female.
Got an idea that'll fly.
Female.
Or open up the mind's eye.
Zoom fly.
Send it to Zoom.
To who?
PBSKids.org. PBSKids.
Thank you.
which team can pop all their balloons first. Samantha B. of St. Paul, Minnesota, emailed us how to play. Here's what you do. You take your balloon and run with it to a chair. When you get to the chair, you have to sit on your balloon and try to pop it. Once you pop your balloon, you run back to the team, and the next player goes. The first team to pop all their balloons wins. Okay, let's play. That means a huge popping sound. Okay, ready.
Are places in museums around the country where you can do activities you see on Zoom. Go to the Zoom website to see if there's a Zoom Zone near you at pbskids.org or America Online. Keyword PBS Kids. Submissions become the property of Zoom
and will be eligible for inclusion in all Zoom media.
This means that we can share your ideas
with other Zoomers on TV,
the web, in print materials,
and in other Zoom ways.
So, send it to Zoom.
Yubble double hubba tubba bubba yubba subu pubba hubba rubba tubba subba yubba alai gabas tubba zubboom jubba strubbite fubba strubby fubba vubba bubba subba mubbass hubba tubba woman strubby fubba hubba. Mama gov on top of the zaboom web up tonight. I like cubby bubby yubbies cubbies, sabbat aboard. Up and roll sub and yabu, double lovey tubby stubby shabu above, zaboom over roll bang.
Funding for Zoom is provided by
the National Science Foundation,
America's investment in the future. The Corporation for Public Broadcasting,
a private corporation funded by the American people.
And by
contributions to your PBS station from viewers like you.
Thanks!
A production of WGBH Boston.